Bill Tweddell.
You'll see very quickly that I don't have the media skills and sophistication of the presenter. I work from tried and tested pieces of paper. Maria, great to be here. Can I acknowledge, first up, Governor Joey Salceda of the province of Albay. Sir, you and your people are very much in our thoughts and our prayers at the moment as you face a great deal of uncertainty over the volcano. Undersecretary Alexander Palmer of the OCD, Assistant Secretary Raymond Liboro of the Department of Science and Technology, the indomitable Maria Ressa, partners in government, private sector and civil society, colleagues from the international community, and ladies and gentlemen, good morning to you. It really is a privilege for me to be with you today for this launch as we observe International Day of Disaster Risk Reduction. Our government, the Australian government, takes great pleasure in our continuing partnership with the government of the Philippines on disaster and climate risk reduction and management. Thank you, Zach, for your comments about our response to past disasters, but if you can't respond well and fully for a neighbour and a friend, then you shouldn't be in business of government, in my view. Today we're very pleased to work with a new partner, with Rappler, new in this space at least, to popularise and communicate this agenda to a wider audience through Project Argos, protecting life, livelihood and investments by helping communities prepare and respond to disasters and climate change through the use of social media and technology. Recent typhoons and floods, and I haven't even been here 3 years, have brought into stark reality the need to prepare better for and to respond to disasters. I really do like Maria's call for prepare, respond and recover. I think that's very catchy and says a lot of what we're on about. I'm excited and energised by the focus and the underlying principles of Project Argos, the principles being that by harnessing technology such as social media and the internet to maximise the flow of critical data before, during and after a disaster, Project Argos serves as an information communications platform that invites citizens and government to help communities adapt to climate change and be ready for disasters. I'm also very excited that the project's aim is to educate and empower the public to take direct action that will save lives and property. I'm sure everybody in this room will all have stories, lessons, and experiences from disasters which have hit this country and others. These stories, which are shared through social media, through Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and others, together with information and data from the Philippines' technical agencies, such as hazard and risk maps, climate data, typhoon warnings, and so forth, will serve as a backbone of Project Argos. Popular understanding of disaster and climate risk reduction and management is essential if we are to make zero casualty a reality, and I congratulate you, Governor, on your response to the last typhoon. It seems to me that for disaster and climate risk reduction and management to be effective, it needs to be easily understood by those who manage disaster preparedness and response and by the population at large. Communities are better placed to prepare for and respond to disasters when they have an understanding of the hazards and risks that confront them, including information on emergency resources which they can access. And Project Argos will play an important role in meeting that need. Project Argos, in our partnership with Rappler, is one of many disaster risk reduction and management activities supported by the Australian government in the Philippines, a partnership we see as completely central to the Australian government's work in this area in the Philippines. Since 2006, the Australian government has been working with the Philippines governments and its mandated agencies, and there are quite a number of these. OCD, of course, USEC Palmer's area, the Climate Change Commission, the Department of Interior and Local Government, the Department of Social Welfare and Development, the National Economic and Development Authority, Housing and Land Use Regulatory Board, agencies attached to the Department of Science and Technology, such as PAGASA and FIVOLX, and agencies attached to the Department of Environment and Natural Resources, such as MGB and NAMRIA. At the local level, and through our civil society partners, we support community-based disaster risk reduction and management by supporting the preparation of land use plans, disaster management plans, implementing disaster preparedness measures like early warning systems, and conducting emergency and evacuation drills. We in the Embassy are working with the Department of Interior and Local Government to assist their plans to secure the safety of informal settlers' families in Metro Manila living along or over dangerous waterways. That work has included at least three facets, socioeconomic profiling of informal settler families along eight major waterways to inform relocation policies and better target social assistance measures, supporting communities in formulating their own people's plans and relocation, rolling out early warning systems and disaster risk reduction training to community leaders and residents. And we're also working in partnership with the Climate Change Commission, the Office of Civil Defence and other technical agencies to support the generation and updating of hazard and risk information through multi-hazard mapping and risk and vulnerability assessment. This information and analysis is critical to effective national, regional and community planning and preparedness. And the work has included the first ever light detection and ranging, LIDAR, technology aerial survey of the Greater Metro Manila area and development of a detailed multi-layered exposure database, which is the key input to assessing risks and planning. Working with the Climate Change Commission and the Housing and Land Use Regulatory Board, Australia has supported the development of planning guidelines that integrate disaster and climate considerations into local planning and local decision making. And provinces across the Philippines were supported in preparing their disaster risk and vulnerability assessments. The reference manual and supplemental guidelines on disaster risk reduction and climate change adaptation integration is now being used in updating provincial, city and municipal land use plans. Australia is also working with partners to promote disaster risk reduction and management through information, education and communication by harnessing technologies to better communicate risk information. Using readily available technologies, we've supported the Climate Change Commission in the development of a climate and exposure database that is now publicly available. Our new partnership with one of the game changers, innovative and pioneering international news organisations based in the Philippines, will take this work now to a new level. We're very proud that we are working with Rappler, whose thrust is to inspire community engagement through digitally fueled actions for social change. Rappler's leader, as most of you here would know, the incomparable Maria Ressa, is respected as a most fearless, most respected, most innovative and visionary of Filipino journalists and writers. And she is ably supported, as many of you know, by a cadre of very talented and young journalists in Move PH. So Project Argos, we believe, is in very good hands. There's no doubt also that the private sector, working with our government partners, can play an important role in promoting and communicating disaster and climate risk reduction and management to a wider audience. Project Argos will make information and knowledge products on climate change adaptation and disaster risk reduction more accessible to the public and help empower communities to act for themselves. So in closing, we in the Australian Embassy hope that all of you will engage with Project Argos, and rest assured, though I am clearly not in Maria Ressa's class as a user of social media, I will be tweeting that Project Argos is a key initiative so we can make zero casualty a reality. Thank you all and good morning. Thank you very much, Ambassador.